Today's video will cover two common methods for calculating pain and suffering compensation in a personal injury case. Brought to you by the Mullen and Mullen Law Firm of Dallas, Texas. So, let's say you get hurt in a car accident that isn't your fault. You've probably been around enough to hear about people in other lawsuits receiving money for pain and suffering. Will you be able to recover damages for your pain and suffering? Like most everything, the answer is, that depends. Here are a few factors that can affect compensation for pain and suffering. How severe are your injuries? How much pain did you experience with your injuries? How did those injuries affect you at your job and in your daily life? What medical treatment did your injuries require? How long will it take you to recover from your injuries? What medication will you need to take to treat your injuries? Are you a credible witness? Were your injuries partially your fault? There are two common ways to calculate pain and suffering damages, per diem and multiplier. One, per diem, aka daily rate. Let's say that after about 6 months, you were finally pain-free. That's about 180 days. The lawyer could argue that your daily pain for the dates in question should be compensated at $200 per day for a total of $36,000 in pain and suffering. Insurance adjusters may argue that the compensation should be less based on severity, duration, and daily rate, among other factors. 2. The multiplier method. With this method, you multiply your medical bills and lost wages by a number. Many personal injury lawyers multiply by 3, but insurance companies have pushed back against this with complex software programs to arrive at lower amounts. The multiplier itself usually changes based on severity of the accident, with higher numbers going to more severe accidents. So, let's say you ended up with $6,000 in medical bills and $2,000 in lost wages for $8,000 total. Multiply that by 3 to get $24,000. Now, some injury attorneys will take this multiplier number and average it with the per diem number. In our two examples, averaging $24,000 and $36,000 results in $30,000. At this point, a demand letter gets crafted and negotiations begin with the insurance company. The process is highly subjective, which is why you want the most skilled Dallas personal injury lawyers you can find on your side. If you've been injured in an accident, call the Mullen & Mullen Law Firm for a free consultation.